I was like, man, when are we ever going to go to a place where we don't get noticed at all?
Anushka, what people in the States would not know is that you guys are the celebrity it couple here. And what's the nickname they have for you?
Virushka.
Virushka.
So they combined Virat and Anushka. They made it Virushka. Yeah.
How did you guys meet and how did you go about asking her out the first time?
So we met at a commercial shoot for a shampoo. And I remember my manager's Bunty, he told me, so you have this brand coming up, and it was a known brand called Clear, Clear Shampoo. And I was like, great, sounds good, this sounds exciting. And I was like, who is it with? And then he's like, it's with Anushka Sharma. I was like, are you kidding me? you got to be joking. He said, no, I'm serious. I was like, how the hell am I going to be in a frame with a professional actor? I'm going to look like a fool. I have no idea how to do this. And then he's like, you'll be fine. Don't worry. It's a nice script. It's all fun and games. And I was like, okay, fine. And then the first time I met her, I cracked a joke immediately, you know, with her. And then...
Were you nervous?
I was very nervous, and that's why I cracked a joke, because I didn't know what to do. And you know, I was standing on set and I was being all nervous and jittery, and then she came in and I was like, yeah, I just cracked a joke in front of her. And then
you remember what you said?
Yeah, I remember what I said. I thought I was being funny, but I just said something which wasn't probably the right thing to say, because she's tall as well, and she was wearing. And she was being told that I'm not that tall. I'm not like 6 feet plus or something like that. And you must not wear like massive heels or anything. So she walked in with this much height of heels. And I saw her and she was looking taller than me. And I was like, didn't you get a higher pair of heels than this? And she was like, excuse me? I was like, no, I'm just joking. So my joke actually became, you know, quite a weird moment for myself. I behaved like such a fool, to be honest. And she was so confident because, you know, she's on set right. Regularly, and I was just like, how the hell am I gonna go through this? But yeah, it was a shoot that went across 3 days. We shot at different times, and then slowly she realized, because she's also from a very similar background as me. Middle class families, made it in their respective careers. Worked hard, got to a certain stage. So actually, in hindsight, when we look at our lives, they were going at the same pace, but in totally different worlds. The timelines of my debut, August 2008, the timeline of her starting her first film, shooting was 2008, August. Same year we, you know, came into the scene. But we didn't know each other till 2013 we met, and then our life has been so similar but in totally different worlds. And then we got along so well because we were talking real things, and you know, we were talking things that a lot of people don't connect with. Only if you've seen that life you will understand what we're talking about. So the connect was there immediately, and then we became good friends, and then yeah, things went on from there.
Wait, so how'd you ask her out the first time?
It was quite like very traditional, you know, we would go out for meals and yeah, we'd just spend time with each other. And then eventually, I mean, you didn't really have to ask out, I guess, because both of us knew that we like spending time with each other. And then, yeah, things, I don't even actually remember any time when we thought of, okay, this is the transition that's happening. It was so organic and natural. Things just kept getting stronger and stronger and stronger, and then we knew that we just wanted to be with each other.
We were talking a bit about this in the car, but what do you think you each have learned from one another?
Well, that's the one thing that people don't register, and I don't think they register till date, is that when you are with someone who's been at the same level as you in terms of being in the public eye, understanding the pressures of situations, they understand you so well, and you can literally speak to them about whatever's going on in your mind because they know exactly what you're saying, and similar for her as well. So the fact that we understood each other's situations, the pressures, the things that we were dealing with, it just, I mean, we absolutely love spending time with each other, and we just had such a strong connect. And as Gagan mentioned, whoever meets us, they immediately tell us, you know, we can feel your connection. It's not even like we are wanting to present something in front of people, but it's just organic, it's just natural. We're like, we literally like, you know, each other's best friend, and we love hanging out with each other. And the comfort of being able to share anything with your partner, I think, is the most amazing thing. And we've both learned different things from each other. I learned a lot of, you know, things of acceptance, things of working on myself, things of, you know, just looking at the world in a different manner, not being closed as a person. And she's learned a lot from my life as well, just, you know, in terms of motivating yourself, working hard on things. And we've just kept learning off each other all the time.
How do you propose?
So the proposal was, again, it just happened very organically. I mean, we've never...
I want to tell you one small instance about when he told us that he's getting married. Uh-huh. So obviously he had been with her for so many years, and we knew they were going to get married because they were in love, and they were still in love, obviously, but they were so close to each other, and we knew this was bound to happen. So he just called everyone. We have a friends group on WhatsApp, and he messaged everyone that come home, and we thought it was a general message of us getting together, like how we used to hang out with each other. And we get to his house, and he said, we're chilling, and then he said, guys, I want to talk to you guys about something. And we go, yeah, so what's up? He said, I'm getting married. I said, yeah, we know. He said, but in 2 months. And we were like, what? It was obviously one of the biggest weddings that had happened in India, because Anushka Sharma getting married to Virat Kohli and massive stars. And
So basically the plan was all executed by Anushka, because I was in the middle of a series, and she figured out the location and everything, and she mentioned it pretty categorically that we have to keep it confidential, and there was no other way around it.
And you guys went to Italy, right?
Yes, but even then, one of the media guys, I think, reached there, but he wasn't allowed to.
He didn't tell us until we landed in Florence.
Yeah.
Wow.
We landed in Florence, we asked the driver, where are we going? He said, I'm not supposed to tell you that.
Nothing, even them.
And you only had 42 people at the wedding.
Yeah,
so it was
wedding
small,
was very private,
right?
Yes. So this was the announcement, and you know, we announced everything, and everyone knew, and there was like a frenzy and prop security, and people had to get in with their cards and stuff like that, otherwise you can't enter. So proper top level stuff. And then we came to Bombay to do another celebration for her industry friends, my cricketer friends, and then two celebrations. So across two celebrations, after they ended, the next day, our family said, we're so glad you did it in Italy. Because they had, and we said, imagine if the main thing happened in India, it would have been madness. They could not handle two celebration parties. And then that's when they realized, okay, what they did was the right thing.
So you're on your honeymoon in Finland. Tell about going to the coffee shop.
I can't believe this. I mean, we go to Finland. We were hoping to see the Northern Lights, but we just could not because it was snowing for all 3 days. And but we were just fascinated and just taken aback by the whole place. It was pure, like white and snow all over, and so clean. Like there was literally no pollution. There was so, you know, so few people around. And then we were like, wow, this place is stunning. You know, beautiful lodge. Then we went to a coffee shop one day in the city center. I was like, feel like having a coffee. It's so cold. You know, coffee would be fun. So we enter the place, and I'm like, okay, this is one place in the world where we haven't seen anyone from India yet. And this is amazing. We're not getting, you know, noticed by anyone, and this is pure freedom. And suddenly I look around, and I look, you know, in the corner of the coffee shop, there's a guy, a Sikh guy with a turban. And I just looked away, and then, you know, I just got my coffee. I was trying to hide from him. And I took my coffee, we went and sat on the table, and I told Anushka, you know, I saw this guy. And she's like, no way, all the way in Finland. I was like, yeah. And then that guy noticed us, and he came to the table, and then he said, so good to see you guys. My last name is also Kohli. And I was like, what are the chances of seeing one Indian guy all the way in Finland, and his last name is the same as mine? And I was like, man, when are we ever going to go to a place where we don't get noticed at all? But yeah, that was funny. All the way in Finland, where we didn't expect anyone to be there, we saw one.